This is an example problem dealing with the charging of an RC circuit. In this problem, we have a 10-volt battery wired in series with a 2-kilo-ohm resistor R and a 5-microfarad capacitor C. They're also wired in series with a switch, which currently is open, and we're told that initially the capacitor is uncharged. The things that we're going to solve for in this problem are the time constant, the current when the switch is first closed, the time for the charge on the capacitor to reach 99% of its maximum value, and the current at that time. Okay, first we'll find the time constant. The time constant, tau, is defined as R times C. So this is an easy thing to find. We just multiply the 2,000 ohms times the 5 times 10 to the minus 6 farads. And we get that the time constant is 0.01 seconds. The only thing to watch out for when you're finding a time constant is to make sure that you've got your resistance in ohms and your capacitance in farads. If you do that, then the time constant will be in seconds. Okay, that's the first part. Next, let's find the time for the charge on the capacitor to reach 99% of its maximum value. Oh, no, I skipped a part, didn't I? Let's see, let's say that's part A. So if we say part B is, let's find the current when the switch is first closed. Okay, so what we'll do is we will use the equation for current in a charging capacitor. The equation for current in a charging capacitor is equal to E, or V, if you want to call the battery voltage V, over R times E to the minus T over RC. Okay, well, when the switch is first closed, the time is zero because the T in that equation is the amount of time that has passed since the closing of the switch. So what we're looking for in this case is I of zero, which will be E over R, just the battery voltage over the resistance, times E to the minus zero. E to the minus zero is one, so the current at time t equals zero is just the battery EMF over the resistance R. So we have that the current at time t equals zero is equal to 10 volts over 2,000 ohms, and we get then that that is I0. Which is 0.005 amps or 5 milliamps. Okay, I'm going to erase the work for the current since I'm running out of room. So pause if you need to write down the work for the current. Okay, next, part C, we'll call it. Part C is the time for the charge on the capacitor to reach 99% of its maximum value. The equation for the charge on a charging capacitor in an RC circuit as a function of time is this, Q. As a function of time is equal to Q max times 1 minus E to the minus T over RC. OK, Okay. So, what we want is for the charge to reach 99% of its maximum value. That means that Q over Q max is 0.99. So let's go ahead and divide both of, sides of this equation by Q max. So we get Q over Q max. Is equal to 1 minus e to the minus t over rc. So we want q over q max to be equal to 0.99. Let's go ahead and solve for t, and then we'll plug the numbers in. So first we'll subtract 1 from both sides. So we have q over q max minus 1 equals minus e to the minus t over rc. I'm going to multiply both sides by negative 1 now, giving me 1 minus q over q max equal to e to the minus t over rc. Now we'll take the natural log of both sides. We have natural log of 1 minus q over q max equals minus t over rc. Okay. Now I'll multiply both sides by minus rc. So we have minus RC times the natural log of 1 minus Q over Q max equals T. And T is what we're looking for. So let's plug in the numbers. T is equal to minus 2,000 ohms. So once again, make sure you put in R in ohms and C in farads. Otherwise, your units won't work out right. So C is 5 times 10 to the minus 6 farads times the natural log of 1 minus 0.99, because we want Q to be 99% of Q max. When you plug all of that in, you get that T is equal to 0.046 seconds. Or 46 milliseconds. All right, we're almost finished. We want, finally, part D, find the current at the time where the charge on the capacitor is 99% of its maximum value. So I'm going to erase the top part here, other than the circuit diagram. We'll use the same equation for current that we used at the beginning. We just plug in for a different time this time. So you have I, function of t, is battery voltage over resistance of the resistor times e to the minus t over RC. So this time, we plug in 10 volts for the battery voltage, 2,000 ohms for the capacitance, e to the minus 0.046 seconds over RC. We already found RC was 0.01 seconds. So you plug that into your calculator. And we get 5.03 times 10 to the minus 5 amps. 5.03 times 10 to the minus 5 amps. Remember, the current immediately after we closed the switch was 0.005 amps. So that's about 1% of the original current. So you can see that as the capacitor charges up, the current gets smaller. And that's because the more charge that you have built up on your capacitor up here in the drawing, the more charge you have built up on the capacitor, the more the positive charges from the battery will be repelled. See, the current is flowing this way, but the more positive charge you've got on the capacitor, the more the positive charges from the battery will be repelled by that capacitor, and less and less current will flow, until finally the voltage across the capacitor is equal to the voltage across the battery, and there won't be any current flowing at all. So we've reached 99% of that point in the last part of this problem. So the current is quite small, but it's not yet zero.